farmers. Welcome back to Griffin, Indiana. A wet Griffin, Indiana. And that is kind of unfortunate because it is the first day of summer. And I got harvesting contracts everywhere. Every field is ready for harvesting except for grass, well, my grass fields. And that sugar beet field that we were fertilizing last episode, I think we did. One thing I will say is I'm very tired of this tanker. Having to fill up the greenhouses every day is fine. Going back and forth, build the tanker constantly, it seemed like, because that's all I've really done. So maybe if I do more jobs in between, it won't be too bad. But I'm actually thinking of upgrading to the other water tanker that can hold at least more gallons of water than what the greenhouses take. Now, why we're on the top of the greenhouses? Because I'm filling up because obviously I can't harvest while it's raining. It is supposed to stop raining sometime in the afternoon hours. The greenhouses, these are the Alien Gem greenhouses from No Man's Land, and they go just about 20, I think it's actually just shy of 24 hours. It seems to be like 23 and a half hours. Can we fill up here? Am I not? Where's the trigger? Trigger? Thank you. So when I go into the shop, I think it showed $250 per hour. That's on hard economy, by the way. I think that is with just water, because I'm getting more than that. I think because I'm adding the fertilizer, we're doubling the profit. We're actually getting, and I'm going to go show you what that's filling up with water. Let's scroll on down here. You can see one day I got $26,400 from the greenhouses, and then $25,300. That's because I'm missing 1 hour per day, because I go until 9 o'clock, because that's when our feeder kicks in for the cows, and then I make sure I give the cows water, and then I come over and take care of the greenhouses. So I'm earning 25 grand per day on the greenhouses. Should have done that a lot sooner, which is allowing me to pay off the loan little by little. We're down to $1.25 million, and I did sell milk, as you can see, a few days ago. There was a great demand for milk. I think it was going for like $1,500, and I had just like $50,000 liters of milk, and we got $85,289 worth of milk at our sell point. That's at our sell point. So if I scroll down a little bit further, I've only did one contract, and that was the sugar beet field for 12354, same field that we've been fertilized before. And you can see I haven't done contracts since, because, well, there hasn't been any for me to do. But the greenhouses are allowing me to pay off the loan by itself. And I think we got the loan payment down to below 8,000. Yeah, so we're just shy of $8,000 on loan interest per day. So that is working out well. Not doing any farm work, paying off a little bit of loan little by little, and then just making money by not doing any work. So that's working out well for us. What's not working out well for us today is, like I said, and you can see, it's raining, and I got contracts everywhere. Every field is ready. So once the rain stops, we'll get the Ideal Combine out, and we'll just start getting to work. The Ideal Combine, I don't know what field we're going to do first. I mean, I could do my own, but I think I'm going to do the contracts first. Yeah, probably do that first. I don't know. Yeah, well, either way, we just got to start harvesting. And I'm going to do the cereal crop fields first, because I want the straw. We're going to bale the straw, sell the straw, bring as much cash. And then, of course, once we get the fields harvested, they're going to ask for them to be either plowed, cultivated, or seeded. And, we're going to go ahead and buy ourselves a seed tanker and a planter and a drill. Probably a drill, because most of them are going to want to be drilled, I would assume. Dump the manure in, because greenhouses, I wish I'd done this a little bit sooner, but you know what, better late than ever, I guess. And we'll get going on these greenhouses, keep them up and going. We got plenty of manure. I'm getting more manure from the cows than I'm using. I have not checked, but I'm gonna check here in a second. I still think we're at 60 cows, and the milk production seems to be a little bit low, but I think it is there we go. I'm trying to remember. I think if a cow is expecting offspring, they don't produce milk. So the cows last year that gave had offspring, obviously they can produce milk. But since they're pregnant again, I don't think they are producing milk. My milk production seems to be down a little bit. And the cows are pretty well, they got their TMR. They got straw. Easy. Yep. Got no brakes. Even with that big weight back there. Yeah, 9,000 liters is a little bit too much for it. I would like to get myself a smaller bucket, but then, you know. All right, let's go ahead and park the Ford tractor in the cow barn to keep it out of the weather and leave the manure that's in the bucket so it doesn't get too wet, because that'd just, you know, be awfully terrible. So we'll check to see how the cows are doing overall. Like I said, last time with the time we knew, we had 60 cattle. I still think we do. Then park this here in the cow barn. Yep, they got straw, they got water, I'm pretty sure they got food. Can you close? Thank you. Let's go to the cattle. Yep, still 60 cattle. Not fertile. Not fertile. But we do have some cows expecting some offspring. Actually, this one here, next animal, pretty darn soon. So the numbers will go up, which is good. That's what we want. All good and going. Yeah, so the manure, even though we're using manure now at the greenhouses, this is increasing still. But that's okay. So what I need to do now is, well, fast forward some time. We got to wait for it to stop raining, we got to wait for the crops to dry. Our grass is actually, is that grass? That's not full height, is it? Is that full height for grass? Hang on a second. Go to back here. We got to turn grass on. Go to here. Our grass is at full height. Our grass is ready to be cut as well. First day of summer. I think, is that what we did last season? I don't remember. Even though it hasn't been that long ago, it's been long enough, I don't remember. I'm coming on down here to check on the hay to see how well we're doing on hay. If we're doing really well, I think we may just go ahead and... So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here we got 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. I got like 20. Yeah, I got plenty of hay. I think what we're going to do is we're going to cut the grass. And we'll leave it in a swath. And we're going to make silage bales out of it. And instead of putting it into the bunker, I think we're just going to go ahead and purchase the baling wrapper. That'll be easier. A lot easier. What is the price of silage going for? Because that's the wrong button. Oh, and I also got to check the price of soybean. Because we're in summer. So the price has got to be good. Well, it was pretty darn decent. 1,100, but it's dropping. So we may go ahead and wait in that. We're checking on silage here. So the biogas plant's 150 flat. So we'll probably just sell it there. We do have access to that. All right, so anyways, fast forward some time here. I got to get the Peterbilt back up here, grab our trailer. The Deutz Fahr is down there. I got to get the baler, which is up here. It seems like half my equipment's down there, and the other half is up here. Yeah, well, I'll get it squared away. I got a couple hours to do so. It's not going to stop raining until about noon anyways. Well, it did stop raining right around 1:30 in the afternoon, and you can see the time is advancing. We're just about at 8 o'clock in the evening, and the crops have not got dry enough to harvest them yet. So, looks like day two of summer may be the first day we actually get to work. There's 8 o'clock. I mean, I could do some harvesting here if they do dry up, but my guess is with the evening dew coming in and the temperatures dropping, the crops are just going to get wet until tomorrow. What my plan of attack is for harvesting all these fields is, and I got other fields I cannot accept contracts to, or they're not coming up yet, because I think maybe I got too many contracts accepted already. I don't know if that's a thing with multiple contracts, but field number 9 is not on the list. I think what I'm going to do, let me go ahead and go in here and let me go to refresh contracts. I think some did come up here. Is field 9 there? No. Well, okay. Hopefully that field does not get harvested. I mean, they shouldn't harvest their fields when it's wet either, I hope. No, they did. Yep, field number 9 has been harvested. They harvested the field. Field 19 was harvested. Those are huge contracts that we missed out on because, well, crap. That's all I'm going to say, crap. I mean, it is what it is, though. We're not going to change anything. We got plenty of contracts anyways, but those are just huge contracts. It's depressing, but you know what? Our greenhouses will make up for it. anyways, yep, see you in the morning. Hopefully the crops are ready first thing in the morning. That'd be great.
Good morning, farmers.
6 a.m. I did pay off a little bit of the loan last night as well, thanks to the greenhouses. And, well, the crops are ready to be harvested, at least for us anyways. Yeah, a little depressing that field number 9 and 19. Those are some huge contracts. Both of them would have been cereal crop fields as well. Sad, but it is what it is. So I don't think actually we're on a plan of attack here. So the contracts that we do have, right now I'm starting off with barley. We're just going to harvest all the barley fields that we can. And of course it starts off with the smaller fields. We're going to do some of the smaller fields together, and in between episodes I'll probably take care of some of the bigger ones. This is already unfolded. I do have a hay bale in here, but that's fine. Can you lower down? Thank you. Turn on. I know I don't have access to this land, and you're going to follow that guy, which is going to be us. Alright, let me make sure we're on the combine. Let's go ahead and unfold the combine. Oh, I better make sure we're in swath dropping mode here. We need to enable that. Alright, let's turn that back off here. Second day of summer, what is the soybean price doing? Soybean price is climbing. So we do have, like I said, 155,000 liters of soybean to sell today as well. Let's go ahead and get to harvesting here. Start getting some. Why? Why are we starting off like this? Someone want to explain this to me? Hang on, is this the field that I can't harvest in certain directions? It might be. Hang on a second. Oh boy, let's not start the day off like this. I knew when the first day of summer came, I was collecting contracts. Also, I'm like, I hear raindrops. I cannot harvest this field. Why not? The crops are dry. Now, I have this problem once in a while with these fields where I can't harvest them for some reason. What's in the field behind me? That's canola. Let me go down to field 25 because that's barley as well. And see if we can harvest that one. Frank is behind us. He'll just do a loop around. Let's see if we can harvest that barley field. Yeah, it's not showing me that the crops are wet, and if they were wet, I should get an indication saying, hey, you can't harvest the field while it's wet. And I'd be like, I know. I've been down that road before. Gotta wait for Frank. He's on follow me, so if I get too far ahead of him, he'll lose track of where we are and get lost. Come on, Frank. Let's go. I know it's early in the morning, but you had all day yesterday off, basically. I just gotta remind myself around 9 o'clock, I gotta head up to the main farm, take care of the greenhouses, and make sure the cows are all set. Okay, so I'm harvesting this field here. Alright, so field 28 might be a little bit of a problem. Maybe by doing some other contracts I can go back and it'll reset itself. I don't know. Where's Frank? Yeah, Frank is coming. Alright, so at least we are still starting with off of the barley fields, but start knocking off some of these contracts. But man, that is sort of a bummer about some of the fields in the southern end of the map. Those are the big ones. And unfortunately, even though we can't harvest, apparently AI can harvest when the crops are wet. But that doesn't affect them at all. Does not affect them at all. Drive in their sugar beets because I'm pretty sure they don't care. They do care, but we're not going to damage them at all. So definitely go ahead and sell the straw and that one hay bale. We'll just sell it straight up. I think we'll go ahead and buy the baling wrapper that we talked about last episode for like 56 grand. And I think our grass fields, we're just going to swap it up the grass, wrap up the silage, and then wait a couple days. You're going to have to wait 2 days for that grass to turn to silage, and we'll bring it on down to the BGA and let them take it. I don't know where all this barley is going to go, but we'll just find out where some of this barley has to go, and then we'll take it one load at a time. But our 10T here can hold 120,000 liters. Okay, wait. What's going on here? Why? Is it because I clipped that field there and it thought it should be harvesting canola? I wonder if that's what's going on here. All right, so before I can do anything else, let me go see if I empty out this combine and start harvesting again, if that clears up the situation. Got the beacons on because we're rolling. I hope this clears up the situation. I remember this problem going way back when FS19 first came out, and that happened to me quite a bit on Ravenport. That's a big sugar beet field. I wonder... I mean, the crops aren't ready yet that I know of, but that might be a contract I may end up doing again. Sugar beet, root crops. It's a long harvest. If the crops don't have to be delivered too far, it's a nice wide open space. Get a worker going on it. Let's see just by emptying the combine that clears up the situation that we got going here. Although it's getting a little clustered around here because Frank is trying to do, you know, he's trying to follow me and... Yep. See if I can back the trailer up and sneak it on in there. Short trailer, long truck. Once the trailer starts to turn, it goes. Take it nice and slow, and hopefully I can get it underneath. All right, let's see if that's recessed the combine. I hope so. All I want to do is combine. That's all I want to do here. That reset it. Yep, that reset it. So a couple things that can cause that to happen. So if you ever have it happen, and it happens usually a lot on other farmers' fields. And that is because if you get like multiple crops on a field, because sometimes they don't get all the edges when they clear the field themselves. So if the combine happens to be harvesting two crops at a time. So like when I turned around there, I clipped the other field, which I have a contract on. And that is canola, I believe. So the combine saw barley and canola, and it kind of gets it all itself a little bit screwed up, I think. At least that's what I think is what happens. And I think with that being said, what I'm going to do is go ahead and get a headland done here. Hopefully Frank can figure this out. So hopefully we can get all the contracts done in one farming day. But I'm running at one time the speed, I should be able to. And after we get it all said and done, if the contracts start coming up to, you know, reseed the fields, we'll go ahead and buy ourselves our seed tanker, our drill, and our planter. And you know what? At that point, I probably will buy our other tractor as well, because I need the Deutzfahr for harvesting our grass. Yeah, the Ford is not powerful enough to run a lot of this equipment, so... about time we get ourselves the other tractor. Now, the question I have with the other tractor is, the other tractor is going to be questionable. And I think it's going to be okay, because the land around here is pretty darn flat. The tractor is going to be questionable with the biggest engine in it to be able to haul our seed tanker and our drill slash planter. The planter should not be much of an issue. It's the drill that requires a lot of horsepower. The planter, not as much horsepower as the drill itself, so hopefully that all works out. But yeah, in a couple days here, I think it should be the very next day, yeah, we should be have ourselves some more equipment around the farm. A lot of new toys and some big toys, some big boy toys. And when the greenhouse is actually bringing the money that they're bringing in, almost 25 grand a day. Well, yeah, they are bringing 25 grand a day.
That's huge.
That is really, really huge. Yeah, this headland should help us out now. So I got some places to turn around. But I'm still just a little bit upset. Okay, I'm a little bit more than a little upset that field number 9 and 19 got harvested by other farmers. It kind of, I figured it might happen, but I was hoping, like, please tell me they can't harvest either. But apparently they don't follow by our rules. But either way, we're harvesting. Like I said, I just got to figure out where this grain needs to go. But what I do is I just fill up the trailer. And I'm going to assume most of it, basically, when it comes to cereal grain on this map, it's going to go to Country View Milling, which is, like, right next to us right here. Or Posey Co-op. I don't know if that's how it's supposed to be pronounced. P-O-S-E-Y. But I think it's going to be pronounced Posey Co-op. Yeah, that's it, Frank. You're doing a wonderful job. These aces. It's kind of good now because if I remember a couple episodes ago in wintertime, we went ahead and repaired all of our vehicles. I did, though, when I got in the combine yesterday morning, the first day of summer, and I was getting ready to come up here, I got like halfway here, then I realized I didn't refuel it. So I had to drive on down to the gas station because I don't have a fuel tanker at that garage yet. All right, so let's not clip the canola in the other field and have that same problem happen again. I love the dual tracks on the Ideal 10T, but the thing is with dual tracks in the front, this thing does not turn that well. I mean, yes, I could have put the single tracks on it, but I figured, you know, to be a little bit more realistic, because we're going a little bit unrealistic with 120,000 liters that it can hold. I said, if we're going to hold 120,000 liters, then we're going to need some dual tracks in the front to spread that weight out a little bit that we're keeping in the combine. Because I think the base game 10T can only hold, I don't want to say can only hold, that sounds stupid when I say it like that, but I think it holds like 18,000 liters. If you look at what we got so far in the combine, we're at 24,000 liters, and it looks like, yeah, we're not even a quarter of the way full yet. So, yes, in between this episode and next episode, I'm going to take care of a lot of the bigger contracts. I'm just doing the smaller one here with you because it just makes it seem time-wise it fits perfectly. But I'm going to go ahead and get some of the bigger contracts done. It's going to be all the barley fields first. Because that's what's going to be in our trailer in the Peterbilt. And then I'll go work on others. I forgot to check. Did I check this morning? 1183 and rising. Yeah, I think we did check it this morning. At least I did. Maybe before I brought you back. I wasn't quite sure. And I wasn't quite sure when the sun was going to rise this morning. I'm like, what time does the sun rise? And the reason why I started right when the sun rose, because it's supposed to rain today as well in the afternoon. So I'm going to be running the game at one times of speed in between episodes trying to get these fields done today. Because I want the cash to come in. Oh, the other thing I should mention, because I checked on it, we don't have 60 cows anymore. I think we're up to 63. I checked this morning, like, oh, well, we got three extra cows yesterday. Which is good. Which is good, good, good. I don't know if they were all females that were born. Last year, somehow we got lucky. 20 of the cattle that were born on the farm, 19 were female. I don't know how that's possible, but they were. And we only really want the females because we're going to be a dairy farm. And yeah, milk cows don't produce that much milk. At least last time I checked, they don't. So I wonder if that's what happened. I'm going to have to go back up and check field number 28, the first field that we started at, and see if I can harvest. It was starting to harvest the field, and it stopped. So I'm wondering if there was a mixture of crop on that field and somehow the combine got seized up there for a second. And of course, like always, when we finish these contracts with all the barley fields, any crop that we got left over with a cereal crop, we're going to go ahead and save because the cereal crop doesn't sell really good until beginning of winter. So everything will be saved. So money-wise, today should be a pretty good day. After I get done harvesting this field, we'll just go over the contracts and kind of see a lot of contracts that I got and roughly how much we're going to get paid. Now, don't forget, we're also going to be selling the straw bales, and usually I get anywhere from like $25,000 to $33,000 per trailer load. And what I mean by per trailer load, our trailer holds 39 bales, and our bales are 20,000 liters apiece. Yes, I got a modded baler because single player, if I was doing 4,000 liter bales, that's a lot of flipping bales to be picking up. Yeah, and yes, I'm even complaining, even though I got an auto loading trailer. So this cuts back, it cuts down on a lot of work. I think us gamers, most gamers call this, you know, when you use mods like that, it's called quality of life kind of mods. To where it's like, you know, I don't mind doing it, but when it comes to it takes up a lot of time and you're trying to make a video, that's where the quality of life comes in. That's very needed. I think I tried it once with I think it was actually the Pacific Northwest when we were doing that challenge, and I was doing bales in our grass field. And I think at the time I just had the 8,000 liter baler, and even then it was a lot of bales, and that's why I modded it to go up to 20,000 liters. I'm like, all right, that seems a little bit more fitting for what we need to do. Now, what I'll be doing, like I said, between episodes, doing a lot of contracts, what I'll be doing is Frank will get into the combine. I think Frank Jr., he's not up yet. It's only 6 o'clock. Frank Jr. likes to sleep in. I'll get him into the Deutzfahr, and he'll be, you know, wrapping up the straw bales. I won't say wrapping up, but he'll be making straw bales, and I'll be in the Peterbilt either, you know, transporting grain, unloading the combine, and also going around picking up bales and going selling those. So expect to earn a lot of cash today. But man, those greenhouses definitely helping off. It looks like it's going to be a really good year here on the farm. Yeah, I wasn't expecting those greenhouses to help out pay out the bills as quite as much as they were. So that's why I decided, you know, yep, we're going to go ahead and buy our planter, drill, and seeder, and our tractor. That's $1 million worth. I believe all the contracts that we're doing, you know, we'll get that money back pretty darn quick. Because actually, as you know, after we finish reseeding fields, they're going to want them fertilized. And once we do all that, we still have some big equipment that we're going to need to buy, but not right away. We're going to need a forage harvester because we're going to be doing corn chaff here for silage. And then at some point, we'll probably dabble into getting the Big M and getting rid of the smaller mower. But that's not really necessary, but we'll probably do it just because. Because that way I don't have to use a tractor to mow. I can just use the Big M. And we'll have plenty of cash at that point, so that's not a thing. But the Big M is going to be kind of like way on down the road, like I said, once we got everything we need, and definitely after I buy a few more fields, because right now we only got one field that we're turning over, and that's field number 30. One last small strip here, and the one thing I gotta remember, do not complete contracts on fields until we pick up all the straw. I did that last season. I think it was actually this field right here. I completed it, and I was only like half bailed on it, and I was gonna go back and do it with you guys, and I completed the contract before I started recording. I came here and I was like, where's all my straw? And I was like, oh yeah, well you hit complete, and all the straw that was on the field disappeared like a fart in the wind. It just went, gone. All right, we're going to go back up to field number 28 here, which is the one way up there. I don't say way up there, it's just there. Let's go ahead and empty out the combine, though. It doesn't really need to be emptied, but we're going to go ahead and empty it. All right, so let me see contracts-wise while we're waiting here. So, I mean, we're not going to count them all because there's a lot of contracts here. As you can see, they're all harvesting contracts. Country View Milling is where this wants to go. I think it says getting paid $5,500 to harvest this field, which is fine. It's $5,500 that we didn't have. We'll get, I don't know how many bales we got here. Let's see, 2, 4, 6, 8, It's like I got about 10 bales. One is a hay bale, and I got probably like a bale and a half in there. So I'm going to get like five and a half grand for doing the contract. I'm probably going to get maybe $2,000 for the straw bales. And the extra grain, I'm probably going to get maybe like a couple grand from that. Okay, so let's try this again. So I don't know why it let me harvest a corner piece, and then it stopped. I'm not sure. Not really sure why I can't harvest this field. Let me just double check here. This is field number 28. Yeah, field number 28. Go back in the contracts. Right here. Field number 28, harvest. Let me try doing that. Nope. Will not let me harvest the field. All right. No problem. I'll just have to cancel the contract. Luckily, it's not a big field. I can probably cancel it, and it may come back up again here in an hour or so. So not that much of a big deal. I'm going to make sure Frank stays ahead of me or near me. So what I need to do now, the next big barley field, I guess field 14 and 15, I can go ahead and do those. There is field number 15. Do I have field number 14 as a contract? I do. So field number 14 and 15 will be next. Like I said, I'm going to go around and just do all the barley fields first. And then wherever the combine ends up, I'll figure out what field is next to me, wheat or oats. Like I said, I'm going to do all the cereal crop fields first so I can get the bales done. And the reason why I want to get the cereal crop fields done first, so I won't need the Deutzfahr to follow the combine to wrap up straw bales, and I can steal that to go do the grass field to cut the grass, because we're just going to cut the grass and go ahead and make silage bales out of them. So I got to buy a wrapper, but I won't buy it until you guys come back. That, like I said, that'll be like next episode for sure. Just waiting on Frank, because Frank is still in work mode, so he can only probably do like 16, 18 miles an hour. So I'll just mosey on down here. I'm not going to bother delivering that grain at the Country View Milling until the trailer is completely full of barley, because my guess is the first load to bring up there won't be for field 18, it'll be for another field they got a contract on, so. But it all adds up in the end, so it doesn't matter. But what I need to do is field 28, right? I need to cancel that contract because I don't want to deliver the barley to the Country View Milling and it takes it for field 28 that I'm losing grain that way. So field 28, we're going to go ahead and cancel that one. Lose all payments, yes. Missing crops, $7. I harvested crops, $7 worth. But we'll go ahead and just do that. There we go. And I'm going to go ahead and take care of all these other contracts. Frank is down here ready to go. But I think this is where we're going to end the episode for now. End the episode for now. like I'm going to continue the episode. So, yeah, all the barley fields. No barley fields in the southern part. So it looks like all the barley fields. Yep, so I got 14, 15, 17, 29. I think I got 17 as well. Field 17 is here. Do I have field 29? I think I do. I thought I saw it before. So I got all the barley fields. 29 right here. So I got them all. I got all the barley fields. I'm going to take care of those first. And just work my way around. But that is going to do it for today, guys. Hopefully you guys did enjoy the episode. I do appreciate you watching as always. I'll catch you again right here in Griffin, Indiana. But until then, have a good one.